Imagine you were just diagnosed with stage 4 cancer, and your doctor tells you there's nothing they can do except swap out your current body for a new one while still keeping all of your memories and consciousness intact. Would you do it? This may be a common decision to make in the very near future, as BrainBridge just unveiled what it plans to be the world's first intelligent robotic system designed to perform complete head transplants. It uses state-of-the-art robot arms, hands, and artificial intelligence to ensure the procedure is precise, efficient, and successful. In fact, this groundbreaking technology would even allow humans to live indefinitely if they so choose. But how does it actually work, and what are the chances of its success? Importantly, BrainBridge currently plans to execute this procedure with a sequence of 7 crucial steps, starting with step 1, preparation. This process starts by preparing both the donor and recipient. The donor is a brain-dead patient with a healthy body, while the recipient is someone whose head will be transplanted onto the new body, with both patients receiving general anesthesia and undergoing a tracheotomy first for respiratory support. Step 2. Cooling. To minimize brain damage, both the recipient's head and the donor's body are cooled to approximately 5 degrees Celsius. This cooling step is crucial for maintaining the viability of the brain during the detachment process. Step 3. Separation. Using advanced real-time molecular-level imaging systems, BrainBridge carefully separates the heads from the two bodies, with special attention being given to preserving the spinal cord and key blood vessels. Step 4. Reattachment. The recipient's head is then positioned next to the donor's body, where BrainBridge connects the head to the donor's circulatory system to maintain blood flow. The spinal cord, esophagus, trachea, nerves, and blood vessels are also meticulously reconnected using ultra-precision surgical instruments. Step 5. Chemical adhesive. Next, a special adhesive called polyethylene glycol is applied to the spine to help reconnect severed neurons, and a specialized implant is placed in the epidural space to promote neuron repair while ensuring the brain forms new neural connections with the body. Step 6. Face and scalp transplant. The recipient's face and scalp are replaced with those of the donor, restoring functionality and improving aesthetic appearance. This new skin is also treated with a special spray to promote healing and prevent infections. Step 7. Post-surgery care. After the surgery, the recipient is kept in a coma for up to 4 weeks to ensure proper fusion of the spinal cord. During this time, life support systems regulate breathing and circulation, and nutrition is delivered through a feeding tube while the patient recovers. And in terms of the recovery and rehabilitation process required after such a complex procedure, the approach is multifaceted. For this, physical therapy and psychological support are crucial for helping the recipient adapt to their new body and regain their motor functions. On top of this, BrainBridge also uses a brain-computer interface headband to allow patients to communicate their needs through thought, turning brain waves into text or speech for the duration of the recovery process. But one of BrainBridge's most remarkable features is its ability to learn and adapt using cutting-edge AI. In fact, the robot's self-learning AI algorithms help it to avoid errors and adjust surgical plans in real time. Furthermore, by analyzing past procedures, BrainBridge is able to continually refine its techniques and improve post-operative care to ensure even better procedures and recoveries for future patients. And while BrainBridge may be a significant leap forward in medical science, it may also bring about a whole new species of human being, where the line between man and machine becomes completely blurred. Just imagine the next step of this technology, where humans could even attach their heads and brains to completely robotic bodies instead, thus gaining what will likely amount to a series of superhuman abilities. This cybernetic integration could revolutionize not just medicine, but also the way we think about human capabilities. Unlike traditional head transplants, this procedure would involve connecting a human head to a fully functional robotic body equipped with state-of-the-art technology. But why? Well, for starters, these robotic bodies will likely offer 4 specific advantages over biological bodies. Number 1. Enhanced strength and durability. Robotic bodies can be designed to be much stronger and more resilient than human bodies, allowing individuals to perform tasks that would be impossible for a regular human. Number 2. Longevity. While biological bodies age and deteriorate, robotic bodies could be maintained and upgraded, potentially extending a person's functional lifespan indefinitely. Number 3. Customization. Robotic bodies can be tailored to fit the specific needs and preferences of the individual, whether for enhanced mobility, specialized tasks, or even aesthetic choices. Number 4. Elimination of disease. Robotic bodies are immune to biological diseases, reducing the risk of illness and increasing overall health and well-being. And it would all work with a simple 5-step procedure. Step 1. Preparation. Similar to the traditional brain bridge procedure, the process would begin by preparing the recipient by carefully cooling and prepping their head for detachment. Step 2. Severing and preservation. Using advanced imaging and surgical techniques, the head is detached from the original body, while preserving vital structures like the spinal cord, blood vessels, and nerves. Step 3. Connection to robotic body. Finally, the head is then connected to a robotic body equipped with artificial systems designed to mimic biological functions, such as circulation, respiration, and sensory feedback. Step 4. Neural interface. Next, a sophisticated neural interface is established between the brain and the robotic body, which allows the brain to control the robotic body's movements and functions seamlessly. Step 5. Testing and calibration. Extensive testing and calibration are conducted to ensure that the brain can effectively communicate with the robotic body, which would most likely involve fine-tuning the neural connections and making any necessary adjustments. And some of the following superhuman abilities could be a direct result, starting with number 1, sensory feedback. The robotic body is equipped with sensors that provide real-time feedback to the brain, allowing the individual to experience sensations like touch and temperature. Number 2, AI integration. Artificial intelligence systems are integrated to assist with complex tasks and enhance cognitive functions, being able to learn and adapt to the individual's needs while improving the overall experience. Number 3, energy efficiency. The robotic body would be designed for optimal energy efficiency using advanced battery technology and renewable energy sources to ensure long-lasting performance beyond a human's typical 14 to 18 hour long period. But one of the biggest questions surrounding this technology is what it means for human identity. If our consciousness can be transferred to a robotic body, what does it mean to be human? This raises complex ethical and philosophical questions about identity, consciousness, and the essence of humanity. Nevertheless, BrainBridge does appear to be pursuing human head transplants, but it's unclear when they will have their first test run. Altogether, though, this technology will definitely give BrainBridge a head start, as the head-to-head race for human longevity is only seeming to heat up. And they're keeping cool heads throughout the entire ordeal,